Welcome back and thanks for watching. If you're new here, this is Mr. S. In the previous video, we spoke about KK labeling Gengob as an idiot and as well as a coward. Well, following up on that accusation or those allegations, the youth of the SWAPO regional leadership has labeled speeches being delivered by KK as reckless. The SWAPO regional leadership warned former cabinet member Kazenambo Kazenambo is against him trying to score tribal points on matters of national importance, calling his statements reckless. Like I said, this comes after Kazenambo Kazenambo calls out the president Hage Gengob, labeling him an idiot, a coward, and an illiterate over the way the government handled the genocide negotiations with Germany. We all know the negotiations that are going on with regards to genocide, whereby apparently the government, you know, accepted little compensation when they are supposed to accept an amount of money that is at least maybe in trillions. Well, the government accepted the money into billions, which was 18 billions, if I'm not mistaken. And apparently the initial agreement was supposed to be a trillion. So Kazenambo Kazenambo, a member of the Ovaherero, the people that are benefiting from this genocide, who was also once part of the negotiation team, made these remarks after announcing he had petitioned the United Nations Office on Genocide Prevention and the responsibility to protect the intervene in the just ended genocide negotiations between Namibia and Germany. Apparently, according to Kazenambo Kazenambo and many other hereros, they are not happy with the way the government settled the negotiations. The amount agreed upon apparently was too little, and it was like a slap in the face to the Namibian people, particularly the hereros and the Namas. And it was alleged that it's like an insult to the Namibian people. So, quoted, says, "We don't accept nor do we take kindly to the reckless insults that were uttered by Kazenambo Kazenambo. Insults of that nature are nothing but a flagrant attack on the integrity of the SWAPO party and the entire rank and file." All 14 regions coordinators said. That's what the coordinators are saying. The coordinators are saying in a statement issued yesterday afternoon pointed out that there has been a trend where party leaders and members are not adhering to the SWAPO constitution, saying their acts erode much of the party's unity objective. And anyone who seeks to incite Namibians against each other or engage in hate speech and tribalism is working contrary to what in SWAPO party stands for. The statement reads, they believe that as a line of defense against any abuse or threats against the president of the party, they have to call out Kazenambo. Insults or abusive language towards our president are unacceptable. In fact, such insults are a blatant attack against the Namibian people who elected the president of SWAPO party to be their head of state and commander in chief. They said the coordinators want Kazenambo Kazenambo against hurling insults at any of the party's leadership. Like I said, we all know Kazenambo Kazenambo from the time when he was in parliament, the way he used to speak, he's still the same kind of person, he still speaks the same way. But they further caution our members not to misuse the instruments to personally gain or to score tribal points on members of nationally importance. The statement reads, the SWAPO regional leaders are Kazenambo's and similar personal attacks on the country's leadership as advancing personal gain for those saying them. And we call upon all members of the party to cease using matters of national interest to launch personal attacks on the party government, the president, and any other leader to score points and advance personal political ambitions or tribal agenda and disregard the party rules and principle, they stressed. According to this article from the Namibian, it says, or it's alleging rather, that Kazenambo is advancing his personal ambitions, his personal desires, that he is not speaking in the interest of the Herero people or the Nama people, but he is speaking for himself to score tribal points. What is your say in this? And then, following up the revelations that have been coming out on the most well-known corruption scheme in Namibia, which is the fish rod scandal or fish rod corruption, the United States of America have finally spoken. And you know, when the United States of America speaks, it speaks louder that everyone in the world hears or everyone in the world listens. So the United States of America has banned the former fishery ministers Bernard Esau and ex-Justice Minister Shanghala from entering the country because of allegations of the corruptions. This was announced by U.S. State Department spokesperson Ned Price in a media statement issued on Tuesday, saying that Price said that the two former ministers were involved in corrupt acts that undermine the rule of law and the Namibian public faith in their government's democratic institutions. Price added that the two men are being accused of undermining public processes and including using their political influence and official power for their personal benefit. And Esau and Shaki Shanghala are accused of corruption involving 175 million Namibian dollars from the fishing sector. The total amount in corruption scheme was estimated, or is estimated rather, at around 3 billion Namibian dollars. And the US also announced that it had blacklisted Esau's family from entering the USA. We are publicly quoted, right? We are publicly designating the following members of Bernard Esau's family who are now also ineligible for entry into the United States: his wife, Soama Esau, and his son, Philippus Esau, Price said. The U.S. said the latest decision reaffirms their commitment to supporting an anti-corruption reforms that are key to Namibia's successful future. The United States continues to stand with all Namibians in support of democracy and the rule of law, and against those who would undermine these principles for personal gain. And the department will continue to use authorities like this to promote accountability for corruption actors in this region and globally, the statement said. So according to the statements, or according to the decisions of the United States of America embassy, they actually apparently it was, the motive was actually to support the Namibian people in the fight against corruption. Could this be true, or could this be one of the moves of, you know, the elite countries, you know, trying to take over Africa, that they extend, you know, a form of support in exchange for something in the future? Because when they come to you in the future and they are looking for something, you are not able to turn them back because they once helped you. And seeing as China now has become, you know, it's controlling a large part of Africa, so this way could be seen as, or could be used as an opportunity, you know, to create a trust relationship between African countries and the United States of America. So that's all from me for this week. All right, guys, thanks for watching. And if you need or for more, subscribe to my channel and as well as like, comments and share so that we engage on this platform. Those likes, dislikes, keep them coming. They, you know, help us improve on the next video. So if you have, I mean, if you have seen something that you don't like, you know, you put it down there, you drop it down there, you tell us what we should improve on, and then in the next video we can now work on that to ensure that you are just given the best content. Thank you.